Hello and welcome everyone to Gold Asset of the Day for the 11th of August 2021, presented by myself, Phil Carr, at the Gold and Silver Club. So as we head into a new week here, what do you need to be aware of? Well, we've just seen in the USA the $1 trillion infrastructure bill get passed. This comes back to exactly what we mentioned to you on the week ahead commodity report. Big opportunities here to take advantage via the industrial metals. In fact, today we're up already 500 points on a new palladium trade that we've executed this week. We've also banked 325 points on crude oil. Not only that, of course, last week we talked you through where we banked gold at $1,830 per ounce. We had four trades on that market, banked 2,200 points. So for every one lot contract that you'll be trading, that's $22,000 of profit. For every 10 lot contract that you'll be trading, that's $220,000 of profit. Now, we talked to you through the big opportunities to be nimble in the market, constantly make sure that you're banking into strength and make sure that you're protecting yourselves ahead of major news items as well. So last week, we of course had the non-farm payroll data come out on Friday, the jobs report. As you mentioned on the week ahead commodity report, we got completely flat on gold, banked at $1,830 per ounce. This, in fact, has enabled us to let this sell-off take effect over the last 24 hours, where gold prices, they've now dropped from the Sunday open of $1,760 per ounce all the way down to $1,674. This has been a real gift for us at the Gold and Silver Club. We've been flat on gold since banking last week at $1,830, so we've built back into positions over this week after the massive drop to the downside. That's really been a great opportunity to reload over the course of this week. So in terms of gold over this week and what we're expecting at the moment, I would look for range bound price action now that we've seen this big correction over the last three sessions and impulse move to the downside. And I'm looking for a retest back towards the 1760 level over the course of this week. We've got the US dollar right now, which is trading back towards the 4 month highs. And we also have the gold to silver ratio, which has had a 3 day impulse move to the upside back at 74-1. I'm expecting a combination of the dollar coming back under pressure, the gold silver ratio rolling over, the gold to platinum ratio is also under pressure as well. So platinum at the moment is picking up momentum versus gold. And we've also just had the infrastructure bill come out, which has benefited us on our crude oil positions, on our palladium positions, and also copper as well. So we've had a great run over the course of the last 24 hours by benefiting off this breakout to the upside as a result of that infrastructure bill, which we've talked to you through multiple times to capitalize on this. It comes back to our point that it's really not a technical market right now. We've seen so many traders out there, they bought gold too high in the last week. They've been hammered basically on the sell-off that we've seen at the beginning of this week. They've been taken out of their positions, been caught with their pants down effectively. And now what we're seeing, of course, is this recovery in price. And you want to make sure that you're not going to miss out on a potential rebound in price. Commodities, they don't move up in a straight line. This is where you want to make sure that you're constantly coming back in and out of the market, banking to strength, then reloading on the sell-off. This volatility is what we need for trading. It's exactly the sort of environment that you want to be able to capitalize on day to day. Already in the last 24 hours, we're up 500 points on palladium. We banked over 300 points on crude oil. Last week, 2,200 points banked on gold. It's this volatility that you want to take advantage of. And this really comes down to utilizing a research-driven approach to the market, where you're utilizing data, market intelligence, statistics, facts, alongside that, the daily, the weekly, the monthly, the quarterly cycles in the market, awareness of capital flows, alongside that, key liquidity zones, the intermarket correlations, the ratios in the market, marry that up to with fundamentals, the macroeconomics, and of course, how the hedge funds, money managers, and institutions are positioned in the market. That will help you massively to get an edge. So with that, if you would like to join our community of successful traders, learn the research-driven approach to the market, and join our professional mentorship program, there is an opportunity for you to do so. Just make sure you click on the link below today's report in order to make an application to join our professional mentorship program.